In this video, I am going to explain muscles that attach to first rib. First rib is this one. But first thing first, I will explain why I focus on first rib today. Okay? So this is profile view. Again, this is first rib. This is the most superior part of rib cage, right? Of course, because this is first rib. Why is this so important? What is inside of rib cage? There is lungs, there is heart, there is trachea, esophagus, and many internal organs are inside of thorax, rib cage, right? Plus, again, first rib is the most superior part of rib cage. So what if muscles around first rib get tight? Maybe that can inhibit breathing, right? Because when you breathe, of course, first rib needs to move. Plus, these muscles are sometimes neck muscle, not only core muscles, okay? Muscles attached on rib cage is also neck muscle. So what happens if these muscles get tight? That can inhibit neck movement. So first rib is like an intersection between rib cage and neck. Does it make sense? Because this is the most superior part of rib cage, and also you can say first rib is kind of the most inferior part of neck. Does it make sense? This is kind of my way to see the body. Okay, first rib, most superior part of rib cage, and also this is the most inferior part of neck. So this is like intersection between different segments. Does it make sense? That is why muscles attaching on first rib can inhibit both breathing, ribcage movement, and also neck movement. Let's get started. Okay, first muscle is this one. This is anterior scalene. Anterior scalene. And this one is middle scalene. Middle scalene. There are three fibers of scalene. So I would like to separate anterior scalene and middle scalene for different muscle. Okay. And the last one is scalene posterior, but this muscle doesn't attach on first rib. This one attaches to second rib. That's interesting, huh? So anterior scalene and middle scalene attach to first rib. Very important part, okay? Next one is this one. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. This is very broad muscle. This muscle attaches to first rib through ninth rib. Very broad. Okay. This muscle attaches to first rib and scapula. This is kind of rare. Other muscles are kind of breathing muscle and neck muscle. And this is what? Shoulder girdle muscle. Very interesting. Very important muscle. Next one is this one. This muscle is in between each rib cage, each rib. This is external intercostalis. External intercostalis. If there is external, there should be internal. Where's internal? Which is this one. This is deep to external intercostalis. This is internal intercostalis. Internal costalis. And there is one more layer in intercostalis. That is the deepest layer. That is why there is innermost intercostalis. These intercostal muscles also, of course, attaches to first rib, very, very important for breathing, for both inhalation and exhalation. Okay, last muscle from this picture, that is this one, this pink one. This is subclavius. By the way, you don't see clavicle. Clavicle is removed. Let's say clavicle is right here. Subclavius attaches to clavicle and first rib, like this. See, many muscles attach to first rib. And let's go back to backside of body and let me explain a few more muscles. Okay, next one is this one. This is part of erector spinae. This is iliocostalis thoracis. Iliocostalis thoracis. It's very lateral part of erector spinae, like this. This is first rib, of course. This muscle attaches to first rib. Next one is kind of a tiny muscle. This is levator costrum brevis. Levator costrum brevis. Levator means elevation. Costrum means ribcage. Then brevis means short muscle. So there is levator costrum longus, but brevis attaches to first rib. This muscle is important for stabilizing thoracic spines and rib cage, plus also inhalation. Very, very important. Now let me explain important anatomical relationship among rib cage, first rib, and today's muscle. Okay, you see new tissue. What is this yellow fiber? This is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus. This bundle of nerve shows up from between anterior scaling and middle scaling. I explained these muscles today. Do you remember? Anterior scaling and middle scaling. What if these two muscles get tight? That can create impingement here. What happens if nervous tissue got impingement? That can create numbness or pain around nervous tissues, right? Of course. One more important place, which is here. What is it? What is this muscle? This is subclavius. What is function of subclavius? That lowers down clavicle. What happens if clavicle is drawn to inferiorly? Maybe that can create impingement around brachial plexus as well. So today's muscles, scaling anterior, scaling middle, and subclavius, these muscles are so important for nervous tissue. Plus, of course, that is important for first rib. Why is this so important? Because this is intersection between rib cage and neck. Plus, there is important relationship with nervous tissue. Does it make sense? So I hope this video gives you new idea for anatomical relationship. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.